Welcome to this YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to talk about top 10 facts about Iran-Iraq relations. So before starting this video, please like this video and subscribe to this channel for our future updates. The political and foreign ties between Iran and Iraq are referred to as Iran-Iraq relations. Both states have centuries of history behind them. Iran and Iraq share a long border, both countries' longest border, as well as a long cultural and religious past. Iraq was once a part of Persia, modern-day Iran, and was part of it for over 1,000 years. The following are 10 fascinating facts about their relationship. Number 10. Following the 14th of July revolution in Iraq in 1958, and the subsequent overthrow of the Hashemite monarchy, which culminated in the country withdrawing from the Baghdad Pact, relations between the two countries became increasingly strained. In the 1960s, Iraq's Ba'ath Party came to power, taking a more militant approach on border conflicts. Saddam Hussein invaded Iran after the Islamic Revolution in 1979, citing border disputes and a desire to exploit oil-rich areas of Iran's territory as justifications. The war lasted 8 years and ended in a standstill. Iraq had used chemical weapons and violence against Iraqi Kurds and Arabs during the war, accusing them of collaborating with Iran. Though Iran did not participate in the multinational coalition against Iraq's invasion of Kuwait in 1991, it was home to a number of Shia political organizations opposed to Saddam Hussein's rule. Number 9. The overthrow of Saddam Hussein in 2003, and the subsequent rise to power of pro-Iranian Shia groups, such as the Islamic Dawah Party and the Islamic Supreme Council of Iraq, resulted in the normalization of relations between the two countries. Over 100 economic and cooperation agreements have been signed between the two countries as of January 2010. Iraq has permitted Shia Muslims from Iran to make pilgrimages to holy Shia sites in Iraq since 2003. Iranian President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad became the first Iranian president to visit Iraq since the Islamic Revolution in 1979 in March 2008. Since 2006, former Iraqi Prime Minister Nouri al-Maliki has paid many state visits to Iran, expressing support for the country's nuclear energy program. Iran has since surpassed the United States as Iraq's largest trading partner. Iran and Iraq are close friends who are fighting ISIS together. The fact that both governments follow a Shiite method of governance contributes to the positive relationship between the two countries. Civilians have protested foreign intervention and the presence of Iran-backed militias threatening and assaulting civilians as Tehran's dominance in Iraqi politics has increased. Number 8. In Baghdad, Iran has an embassy and 4 general consulates in Basra, Sulaymaniyah, Erbil, and Karbala. Iraq has 3 consulate generals in Kermanshah, Avaz, and Mashhad, as well as an embassy in Tehran. On September 7, 2018, Iraqi people set fire to the Iranian embassy, as part of a series of demonstrations, and arson against a foreign force that they perceive as having too much influence in local politics. On November 27, 2019, Iraqi protesters set fire to the Iranian consulate in Baghdad. After the Ottoman-Persian Wars of the 16th and 17th centuries, Iran, known as Persia, prior to 1935, and the Ottomans battled over Iraq, then known as Mesopotamia, and full possession of the Shatt al-Arab, before the Treaty of Zuhab was concluded in 1639, defining the two countries' final boundaries. The Shatt al-Arab was regarded as a vital shipping route for both countries' oil exports, and in 1937, Iran and Iraq concluded a treaty to end the conflict. Iran and Iraq both signed the Treaty of Sadabad the same year, and the two countries' relations remained cordial for decades. Except at Abadan and Khorramshahr, where the boundary ran along the Thalweg, the 1937 treaty recognized the Iran-Iraq border to be along the low watermark, on the eastern side of the Shatt al-Arab, deepest part of the river valley. As a result, Iraq gained ownership of the bulk of the waterway, and Iran was forced to pay tolls if its ships used it. Number 7. Both countries joined the Baghdad Pact in 1955. The overthrow of the Hashemites in Iraq in 1958, however, brought to power a nationalist government that immediately abandoned the pact. We do not wish to refer to the past of Arab tribes residing in Al-Awaz and Mohammare, Khorramshahr, Iraq's new leader, General Abd al-Karim Qasim, announced on December 18, 1959. Mohammare, which was part of Iraqi territory at the time, was handed over to Iran by the Ottomans. The Iraqi government's displeasure with Iran's occupation of the oil-rich Khuzestan province, dubbed Arabistan by Iraqis and home to a significant Arabic-speaking population, went beyond rhetoric. Iraq began supporting secessionist movements in Khuzestan and attempted, but failed, to raise the question of its territorial claims at an Arab League conference. Number 6. In 1978, when Iranian agents in Iraq discovered preparations for a pro-Soviet coup d'etat against Iraq's government, relations between the two countries improved briefly. When Saddam learned of the plot, he ordered the execution of thousands of his army officers and expelled Ruhollah Khomeini, an exiled leader of clerical opposition to the Shah, from Iraq as a gesture of reconciliation. Despite this, Saddam regarded the Algiers agreement as merely a ceasefire rather than a conclusive agreement, and he awaited an opportunity to question it. Number 5. From 1921, when Britain elected Faisal ibn Hussein as the king of the newly founded Iraq. Until 2003, Iraq was Iran's most hostile neighbor, writes Mohsen Milani. Following the 1968 Ba'athist coup, and the subsequent withdrawal of British forces from the Persian Gulf area, their rivalry was particularly fierce. The British also played a part in the 1921 Persian coup d'etat, which resulted in the Pahlavi dynasty becoming Iran's rulers in 1925. Reza Shah's Iran was in financial trouble in the 1920s, so he pursued good relations with his neighbors, including Iraq. Iran and Iraq were adamantly anti-communist and pro-Western nations. They have worked together to avoid the creation of a Kurdish state. Number 4. During the Shah's reign in the 1970s, Iraq, with the aid of other Arab states, battled Iranian influence, which was backed by the United States, as part of the Twin Pillars policy. In Khuzestan province and Iranian Balochistan, this took the form of supporting insurgencies against the Shah. In 1971, the Shah attempted to stage a coup against Saddam Hussein, and assisted Sultan Qaboos of Oman in putting down an Iraqi-backed uprising. He also supported Mustafa Barzani's Kurdish insurgency. Iran and Iraq signed a demarcation deal in 1975, as a result of the stalemate in the Kurdish uprising. Number 3. When the US-led war on Iraq began in 2003, Tehran was outspoken in its opposition to the invasion, calling for the UN to play a key role in Iraq's reconstruction. Iran then decided to help Iraq rebuild after the war, and bilateral ties started to improve. Iraq formed a transitional government in May 2005, headed by Ibrahim al-Jafari of the pro-Iran Islamist Dawa group. Iranian Foreign Minister Kamal Karazi visited Iraq in mid-May, and Jafari visited Iran in July. Iraqi President Jalal Talabani visited Iran in November, making him the first Iraqi head of state to do so in nearly four decades. The exchange of high-level visits between Iran and Iraq has enhanced bilateral cooperation in all fields since 2005. Former Iraqi Prime Minister Nouri al-Maliki makes regular visits, as does Jalal Talabani. In December 2009, Iraq accused Iran of seizing an oil well near the border, sparking a war. Number 2. Iran and Iraq signed an extradition deal on April 24, 2011. Following an Iraqi raid on Camp Ashraf, the home of Iran's People's Mujahideen, the two countries' justice ministers met in Tehran for a high-level meeting, MEK. Iran and Iraq have classified the MEK as a terrorist group. Since the US withdrew and ISIS rose to power, Iran has played an increasingly prominent role within the Iraqi government and security forces. There have been several reports of Iranian militant groups attacking and capturing civilians in Basra alone. Several months of protest and arson culminated on September 7, 2018, in an attack on the Iranian consulate in Iraq, which was set ablaze by rocket fire. On April 9, 2019, a day after the US designated Iran's IRGC as a foreign terrorist organization, Iraqi Prime Minister Adel Abdel Mahdi stated that he had spoken to all parties and attempted to overturn the US decision. Iran intercepted an Iraqi oil tanker in the Gulf in August 2019, and detained seven sailors on suspicion of smuggling fuel for some Arab countries. Iraq denied any involvement with the ship and said it was looking into the matter. Number 1. Iran has a significant role to play in Iraq's reconstruction. In 2007 and 2008, Iran's non-oil exports to Iraq totaled $1.8 billion and $2.3 billion, respectively. More than 40,000 Iranians visit Shiite holy sites such as Najaf and Karbala each month, buying religious souvenirs and contributing to the economy. Iran supplies Iraq with automobiles, building materials, drugs, vegetables, spices, fish, air conditioners, office furniture, carpets, and clothing. Each year, Basra imports $45 million worth of Iranian products, including carpets, building materials, fish, and spices. At the nearby Shalamche border crossing, 100 to 150 commercial trucks move goods from Iran to Iraq every day, 2008. The two countries had signed over 100 economic and cooperation agreements as of January 2010. In 2013, trade between Iran and Iraq amounted to $12 billion. The construction, food, and manufacturing sectors are the key areas of trade between the two countries. What do you think of our list? Let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go.